The Dual Toxocyst is an infested weapon from the biolab in a clan dojo. The basic version is a low fire rate semi-automatic pistol, delivering mostly puncture damage with high status, but terrible crit stats. However, with the Incarnon upgrade, it can become a monster. What does it do, and how can you make that work for you? I'm the Kengineer, let's solve a practical problem. Without upgrades, the Dual Toxocyst is mediocre at best. Low damage, low fire rate, nothing special. On headshot though, it gains a huge 150% fire rate bonus, multiplicative with other fire rate buffs, as well as reduced recoil, 100% ammo efficiency for infinite ammo, and plus 100% additive toxin damage. The buff can be endlessly refreshed with more headshots. This gives it more power of course, but it's still not amazing yet. So enter the Incarnon Genesis. Obtained from the circuit on Steel Path, this upgraded version has 3 sets of evolution perks to pick from, as well as of course the Incarnon mode. The Incarnon mode makes the damage types a little more evenly distributed, increases the critical chance from 5% to 11%, increases the critical damage from 2x to 3x, the fire rate from 1 per second to 4.5 per second, and the status chance from 37% to 43%. On top of this, the shots now ricochet to one other nearby enemy. But perhaps most significant of all, the Dual Toxocyst also becomes fully automatic, allowing for a very easy time with the incredible fire rate buff. Despite transforming to a new weapon functionally, it still can trigger and use the headshot buff, including that ludicrous fire rate increase and toxin bonus. As a slight downside however, the Dual Toxocyst Incarnon mode, like all Incarnon guns, gets no benefit from ammo efficiency, so you don't get a completely endless weapon. Still, that's going from a 1 shot per second weapon, with means to get 2.5 per second, to a weapon that can hit 11.25 shots per second before even being modded. Like most Incarnon guns, charging the Dual Toxocyst requires headshots in the normal form, with multi-shot hits granting additional charges per shot. Just 9 hits are required to fully charge the 270 round Incarnon magazine. Also like other Incarnon guns, the Dual Toxocyst doesn't stop there. We have the 3 evolution perk sets to consider. As is standard with the circuit Incarnons, Evolution 2 offers 2 perks, both with increased base damage as well as an additional feature. Carnage Rain offers plus 60 base damage to go alongside the base 75 damage of both the normal mode and Incarnon mode, as well as plus 33% direct damage per status on the target. This bonus is a very weak version of Condition Overload and Galvanized Shot. Not only is the value low, 33% compared to Galvanized Shot's max of 120%, but also the bonus only scales from the innate base damage of the weapon, not the evolution bonus. The other Evolution 2 perk, Fevered Frenzy, is much more helpful. While the base perk only increases damage by plus 50 instead of plus 60, you then also gain plus 5% multi-shot per ability cast in the mission, with no duration on the perk. This caps out at 100% multi-shot after a 20 ability cast, additive with other multi-shot bonuses, and lasts for the entire mission thereafter. The increase in multi-shot means faster charging of Incarnon mode, higher damage output, and higher status output, making this simply the optimal choice. This is true even if you're in an Aras main, casting abilities once every blue moon. It turns out that transferring to Operator also counts as casting an ability, though transferring back in does not. While a little tedious, that does mean you can freely score your 20 ability casts before even moving from the start of the mission. Now as for the Evolution 3 perks, these are usually token benefits for the circuit Incarnons. Indeed, in the case of the Dual Toxocyst, one option is Evolved Autoloader, a passive reload whilst holstered. This feature doesn't help the Incarnon mode at all, while the normal mode is reloaded when you switch modes anyway. Skip this perk. Another perk is Ready Retaliation, granting a 100% reload speed bonus when reloaded from empty. In testing, it did only apply on emptying the magazine, though rather than increase the reload speed, it appeared to instantly complete once halfway through. Same end result, just a different way of doing it. This perk is also functionally useless, as you shouldn't be getting to the end of the Dual Toxocyst normal magazine anyway with its infinite ammo on headshots, and the switch back from Incarnon mode is very quick. This just leaves us with the perk Marksman's Hand, reducing recoil by 50%. On its own, it's a neat feature to have, but when combined with a max rank secondary deadhead that also grants minus 50% recoil, it completely eliminates all recoil from the gun permanently. This makes the weapon perfectly steady, rather than having any bucking or shaking when the headshot bonus wears off. Given the other 2 perks are close to pointless, Marksman's Hand is an easy pick. Finally then, we come to Evolution 4. Neurotoxin offers plus 70% toxin for 3 seconds on headshot. Considering you already get plus 100% from the weapon innately, this bonus isn't offering anything more than a stat boost, and a modest one at that. Ripper Rounds has a more enticing perk, granting plus 3 punch tree for 7 seconds on killing an enemy, potentially enhancing the multi-target effectiveness of this weapon. However, that just cannot compete with Commodore's Fortune, boosting the base critical chance of the Dual Toxocyst by 20%. Specifically, that means the normal mode goes from 5% to 25%, and the Incarnon mode from 11% to 31%, all before mods are applied. It's hard to justify a punch through or mild toxin bonus compared to such a significant boost to critical hits, especially combined with the base 3x multiplier of the Incarnon mode. All this to say then, the three evolutions to pick for the Dual Toxocyst with no variation to consider are Fevered Frenzy, Marksman's Hand, and Commodore's Fortune. They're simply the best options. Now, being a secondary weapon with limited slash and no forced impact, we can't really build for any kind of slash build on them. Instead, we can use the high crit and status to go for a hybrid build, with your choice of either Viral Heat or Corrosive Heat. Viral Heat has the benefits of Viral procs being incredibly strong and applicable to all factions, while Corrosive Heat has the benefit of tearing through Ferrite armor, which covers many of the more threatening units, including Acolytes. Alongside the choice of elements, you can build in two ways. The first is this no aim build. It's not that you can't aim, but simply that you don't need to. Pointing in the direction of enemy heads is sufficient to trigger all the relevant bonuses and unleash a torrent of damage. Thanks to the extreme status output, Galvanized Shot still ends up being a worthwhile pickup, even with it having no effects on the bonus damage from Evolution 2. As for the Exilus slot, you can pop in your choice of targeting subsystem, which grants you extra accuracy whilst aiming, should you need that little extra bit, or suppress if you're going for a stealthier approach, such as with Avara. The Dual Toxocyst aren't the most precise weapons with only 16 accuracy, which is why targeting subsystem is a pickup to consider. Alternatively, for even more critical power, we can switch over to the aim build. We're swapping out one of the 60-60 elemental mods to instead use Galvanized Crosshairs. Despite being a status-focused weapon, we can get so much direct damage that keeping this and Deadhead running is nearly effortless. Otherwise, the same guidance applies, using either targeting subsystem or suppress, depending on if you need accuracy or stealth, and your pick of elemental setup. Be advised that due to the toxin bonus from headshots being considered after all mods, there is no way to get Viral Heat or Corrosive Heat with just two elemental bonuses modded in. If you try to go for just Cold Heat, those two will combine into Blast rather than combining Cold with Toxin for Viral. Still, it's easy enough to go for Viral, Corrosive or Toxin setups to handle the vast majority of enemies. For Arcane choice, you can either go with Deadhead as a reliable standard pick or look to Cascadia Flare. While Cascadia Flare seems to have a higher maximum damage bonus of 480% versus the 360% of Deadhead, Deadhead has a second headshot bonus and a recoil bonus. Still, you can use Flare on the Heat Viral or Heat Corrosive setup, particularly if you're using it against boss units where you may not have many normal enemies to charge Deadhead against. For status immune boss fights, look instead to Cascadia Accuracy for a temporary critical buff, as well as removing Galvanized Shot for Hornet Strike instead. All told, the Dual Toxocyst Incarnon is a rather simple, reliable, and easy to use weapon. It stretches the definition of single target with its Ricochet perk, but still rewards some attempt at aiming. If a bullet hose headshot secondary is what you're looking for, this will do the trick. That's all for me on this gun. If you found the video helpful, make sure to subscribe, and as always, build charges, proc toxin, and fight well, Tenno.